Hello friends, in this session we will be talking about partnership. We'll first of all understand what do we mean by partnership and the different types of partnership and type of partners, and we'll also understand what is the use of partnership concept. So let's first of all understand what do we mean by partnership. Now, association of two or more persons by investing capital in a business for some period of time is called partnership. Now, supposing two people want to run a business, they will have to, for any business, we need to invest some money into it. Now, if two or more people are sharing the money, two or more people are investing the money in the business for some period of time, or for, and that period of time could be a small period or a long period of time, then it is called, this association is called partnership. And these people who are involved in it are called partners. Now, since the business is owned by multiple people, now we are saying two or more people are there, right? So profit will obviously be shared amongst them, right? So instead of, if we compare it with a single owner run business where there is one owner, all the profit goes to the single owner. Now, as against this, if we are talking about a partnership, the profit will be shared amongst them. Now, the important thing to note here is that the profit cannot be shared equally. There have to be different terms and conditions depending upon the capital. Capital means the money. So depending upon the money that they have invested, the time that they are putting in, and there may be other factors, all those factors will decide how much profit is to be given to one person, how much is to be given to the other person and the third person. So this is not a equally shared profit kind of a partnership always. In some cases, yes, it could be shared equally, but this is not the default way of sharing the profit. Now, the important thing that comes to our mind is, what is so important about partnership? And what is the maths involved in it, right? So let's first of all understand different concepts related to it, and then we'll see how is maths coming into picture. So let's first of all see what are the types of partnership. Now there are two types of partnership. First is simple partnership. What do we mean by simple partnership? It means that if the capital is invested by multiple partners, then they are invested, the capital is invested for equal period of time. Now, supposing let's for some time assume that it's a short-term business plan. And that short term, let's take it to be 1 year. So if there are 5 partners, all of them invest the money for 1 year, which is the duration. Now that 1 year could be 5 years, could be 10 years, could be 6 months, whatever be the time duration, but all the partners are investing money for the same period of time. That is simple partnership. The second type of partnership is compound partnership. What is compound partnership? If the capital invested by all the partners is invested for different periods of time, then it is called compound partnership. So what does that mean? Now, say for example, we have A, B and C as partners. Now, A invests the money for 6 months. B invests the money for 8 months. And C invests the money for the complete 1 year. And this A is investing his money for the initial 6 months. But B starts investing it after initial 2 months of starting the business. So this kind of partnership is called compound partnership. It is not simple that I give 50 rupees, you give 50 rupees, the third person give 50 rupees, and then we have 150 rupees to start a particular business which runs for say 1 month. Now that is simple. But if I am giving 100 rupees and the other person says that he sees it for 5 days, and then he says, okay, now I can also invest 50 rupees. And the third person comes in later. And the fourth person starts in the beginning. He invests, say, 20 rupees. But then after 10 days, he needs the money back. So he takes it back. So this kind of partnership is called compound partnership, where the sum invested is invested for different durations. So now let's take a look at simple partnership in detail. Now in simple partnership, the amount invested by the stakeholders can be different. So we are saying the time duration, amount invested can be same or different. As I just mentioned in the example, if I am investing 100 rupees, the other person could invest 20 rupees or 50 rupees or any other thing, but everybody is investing for the same time period. This is fixed. Now, in this type of partnership, the profit sharing becomes simple. This is where the mental ability or the maths part come into picture, where we need to calculate how the profit would be shared. Now, this profit sharing would be very simple. How? Profit would be directly proportional to the share of investment. So we can also say that investment ratio will be equal to the profit ratio. If we have two people, A and B, A invests 1000 rupees and B invest 2000 rupees. Now their investment ratio is 1:2. That means if the profit at the end of the business tenure is 500 rupees, the profit ratio of A is to B is also going to be 1:2, which means 1/3 into, let's take it to be 600, so that we have simpler calculations to do. So A will get a profit of 200 and B will get a profit of 2/3 into 600, which is 400. So the profit is 200:400, again coming in the ratio of 1:2. So in simple partnership, the concept is plain and simple, that they are investing their money for a fixed, same, equal time periods. But the amount that they are investing may be different. So the profit has to be in the ratio of their investments. So very plain and simple. This is the simple partnership. Now let's come to the compound partnership. Now in compound partnership, the amount that they invest can be same or different. And this was also true for simple partnership. But the important thing here is that the time period for which they have invested can also be same or different. Right? So in this type of partnership also, the basic rule has to be followed that the profit sharing has to be based on their share of investment. So profit of each partner is directly proportional to his or her share of investment. Now, but the important thing is that the share of investment here in the case of compound partnership is not just the amount. This will be capital multiplied by the time for which the investment was made. So again, the same rule applies, which means that the investment ratio should be equal to profit ratio. This is very simple in the business, that the amount, whatever is your investment, your profit have to be proportional to that. So again, let's take an example of A and B. Now again, A invested 1000 rupees, B invested 2000 rupees, but A invested the money for 2 years and B invested the money for 1 year. So now their share of investment for A becomes 2 multiplied by 1000, which is 2000, and share of investment of B becomes again 2000, which is 2000 into 1. So they are now, their investment ratio is 1:1, which means if they are making a profit of 600, their profit has to be in the ratio of 1:1. So both of them will get 300 rupees profit. So this is the difference between simple and compound partnership. Now let's move to the different type of partners. So one was different type of partnership, one is different type of partners. How could the partners be different? We again have two types of partners. One is the working partner. Now what do we mean by the working partner? Working partner is, besides the capital investment, this partner is actively working in the functioning of business. So this working partner is playing an active role in the business. The second type of partner is sleeping partner. Now this person just invests capital and this partner is not working, not active in the functioning of the business. So this partner is called sleeping partner. Now again, just by looking at these type of partners, the obvious thing that comes to our mind is that even if their capital investment is equal, supposing both of them invested 1000 rupees each, we have A and B. Now we are just talking about two people, but there could be more number of partners in a business. So now supposing A is a working partner and B is a sleeping partner, the obvious thing that comes to the mind is that both of them should not be getting equal profits. The profits should be different depending upon if they are working in it or they're just investing money. So now it is understandable that the working partners and sleeping partners should have different shares of profit. And then it is important to understand that it is collectively decided in the beginning. What percentage of profit would be given to the working partner depending upon his or her skill, role, and the time that the person is investing into the business? So, percentage of profit depending upon the skill, role, and time devoted by working partner. So, supposing we have again two people, A and B. This is the working partner and B is the sleeping partner. So, it is decided that he will get 10% of the profit just for his skill, role, and time that he is devoting to the business. Now, the remaining 90% of the profit is divided with the same concept where we say investment ratio is equal to the profit ratio. Right? So, capital investment ratio here will be equal to the profit ratio, but the profit that we'll be taking, considering here, is the remaining 90% of the profit, because 10% it is initially decided in the beginning only that 10% of the profit is going to A for all his time that he's spending, for his role that he's having in the business, in running the business. He's already getting the 10%. So 90% again follows the same rule that we talked about in the earlier part of this session. So now let's understand what is the use of partnership related concept. Now it is very obvious. We obviously see in our day-to-day life that many businesses are run in partnership. They are not single owner based businesses. So if you are starting a new business, the capital requirement is there, right? So the capital, lot of capital is required for starting a business. Now if we have multiple partners, then there the capital investment becomes easier. They are able to invest more and run their business in a smooth manner, right? So if one person may not be able to invest a huge money to run a particular business, but when there are a group of friends or like-minded people coming together, it becomes easier to get that much of capital. Now, the second important thing is that the partners may have varying skill, varying investment capabilities. One is able to invest 1,000 rupees, the other is able to invest 5,000 rupees. And third thing is that they may have different time spending capability. So now the people who will come together may have varying skills which will help the business. They may have different investment capabilities and different time spending capability into the business, and their profit, if we have this concept, the profit can be divided amongst the partners proportional to their skills, their investment, their time, and it becomes easier to run a business. And for this, it is very important that the profit sharing has to be proper. The profit sharing should be done in a proper manner, which is justifiable, which is fair. So these partnership concepts are very useful in coming up with the terms and conditions of business in the very beginning. So this is a very useful concept in our day-to-day life. Friends, you can visit us at our Cool Smart Learning website and subscribe to our YouTube channel to get more updates on the new video sessions.